I kind of agree with Trump on this one. So we had, it's always a good laugh when you're dealing with Trump. I don't mind laughing at the damn dude because he's a buffoon, an idiot. But sometimes I do agree with him, right? Even the broken clock is right twice a day. This report came out and it says that Donald Trump has slammed Joe Biden's administration for his handling of the Mexico border crisis as shocking figures revealed border crossings hit a 21-year high last month. As it was revealed, more than 180,000 had been stopped at the frontier in May. Trump described the situation as worse than ever before. It says, in the history of our country, it has never been more dangerous or worse, Trump said in a statement. At no time in our country's history has anything so outrageous taken place, he wrote. The Biden administration stopped construction of the small remaining openings in the areas of the almost 500-mile-long wall, having taken away all authority from our great border patrol. And Trump says here that, and they have ended such long-fought-for policies, including Remain in Mexico, Safe Third agreements, and our hugely successful program that completely stopped catch and release, he added. Millions of people are pouring through our border, including many criminals, being released from jails for such crimes as murder, drug smuggling, and human trafficking. They do not have long to act as our country is being destroyed. Then it goes on to say that the migrants stopping at the border are at the highest since April of 2000. According to a new data released by the U.S. Customs and Border Protection, CBP, on Wednesday, the agency made 180,034 apprehensions in May, a small increase from the 178,854 made in April. God damn, you got like 180,000 people coming across a month. It says the numbers topped 173,337 in March, making this year the first since 2000 in which at least 170,000 apprehensions were recorded three consecutive months in a row. And Trump is, and the Republicans are bashing and dismantling Biden on this border wall. And I would say, for good measure, I know that crisis at the border ain't looking good. Now, this is where the next story I'm about to read is, now we're going to talk about Joe Biden, right? I'm going to talk about Trump, and then Trump's going to lead us right into Biden. So this is the last story for Trump, which is set us up perfect to get into Joe Biden. But I'm going to play this video before we do it. Those banditos are causing issues. Yeah, there we go. There go the racism. I knew if I put that Trump in the title. Anytime you put Trump in the title, the racists don't come out. Okay, let's go. Let's play the video. I ain't got time for the racists, man. Just don't get too crazy because I time y'all. I don't give a damn if it is seven people in here. It'd be one in here fucking with me. I'ma time your ass out. Don't come in here with that bullshit now. Let me play the video. Try me if you want. I'll show you how I get down.
I've been asked to go by a lot of different people, including Border Patrol. These are great people that work in so hard for our country. And I've been asked to go, so I'm seriously considering it. It could happen relatively soon. Just to support these incredible men and women who have done such a good job. And, you know, they just left out to dry. It's disgraceful that nobody's been there from the administration in terms of the top is this. Really terrible.
All the shit about the criminals, the rapists, the drug dealers. I'm not with all that shit there, man. You know, he was saying that before the border shit. They're not sending their best, their brightest. They're sending the drug dealers, the criminals, the rapists. Right. Basically indicating that all brown people were criminals, drug dealers, and rapists. So I'm not gonna get into all that dumb shit. But I will say, but for humanitarian purposes and otherwise, the border crisis is a problem. It's definitely a problem, man. What, calling them banditos? Oh, ain't nothing racist about calling the banditos. What did you just motherfucker say? He said what? The banditos are definitely causing issues. What? Who's the banditos, man? Okay, it ain't racist. What does banditos refer to? What does banditos mean? Who are you talking about? There's nothing racist about it. So who are you talking about when you say the banditos? Who are you talking about? I'll let you get some time to think about that as I pull up the next story. You tell me who you talking about when you say banditos. Who you mean? Who's the banditos? Oh, you thought you was being funny? Yeah, I forgot to laugh. So after Trump slammed Biden on that border crisis, you heard him say that he's going to visit the border. I think him and Governor Abbott, actually from Texas, on June 30th, they slammed Biden and Harris refusing to visit the border. It says Trump has released a statement on Tuesday saying that he will accept Governor Abbott's invitation,
then tore into Joe Biden and Harris administration for refusing to visit the border. It says the former president said that Biden had dismantled the secure border he ensured. So basically, Trump is saying he had the border nice, safe, and secure. Part of it being safe and secure, Trump thinks separating children from their parents and never reuniting them and stripping babies from their mothers, he thinks that's securing the border. That's his definition of secure, because it wasn't the criminals, the drug dealers, the rapists, the sex traffickers that he was doing this to. He was doing this to women and mothers, stripping them from their children and separating families. Those wasn't the rapists. Those wasn't the murderers. Why was he doing it? I can see it. Why was he punishing the murderer? Where's all the rapists, the murderers, and the drug smugglers and the sex traffickers? Oh, that's right, because we already have laws to take care of those people. And then none of that shit he was doing at the border when it was housing them people in them facilities, separating them migrant children from their parents. Guess who wasn't in there? There was none of the drug dealers, the criminals, the rapists. Those was mothers, fathers, grandmothers. He was basically destroying families. So I don't know what the hell did Trump be talking about or Trump supporters be talking about, because his policy wasn't stopping the criminals. Like he liked them type of rapists and all that type of stuff, right? It's like he was giving them a pass, because all he was doing in the facilities that he opened up that Barack Obama built and then Trump put into use was putting mothers, women, and children in these facilities. That's the part that we were mad at. Okay, the drug dealers, the criminals, the rapists, the drug smugglers, the human traffickers, we don't mind if you send them back or lock them up or do whatever you want to them type people. We had the problem with the mothers, the grandmothers, and the grandfathers that you were separating the babies from. And then also the reports came out where they were taking women and sterilizing Mexican women, making it to where they couldn't bear children no more. In one instance, I think they took out a woman's womb. They were taking them into surgery, telling them that they need this certain type of surgery, they need that, lying to these women. These women didn't know what the hell they were signing for. Actually, language is a complication. And they were sterilizing the woman at the goddamn border in these facilities. They were sterilizing, meaning once the woman left the facility and went back to Mexico, they couldn't have any more children. That's the type of shit that we got a problem with. The banditos, you dumbass. That's the type of shit that I got a problem with. I don't got a problem with you do with the rapists, the sex traffickers, the pedophiles. Oh, you ain't gonna do nothing to them, because that will put him on blast, because he's one of those type people. Anyway, like I was saying, so he's supposed to be visiting the border with this Texas governor, Greg Abbott. It says Biden and Harris have handed control of our border over to cartels, criminals, and coyotes, Trump said. Our nation is now one giant sanctuary city where even dangerous criminals are being cut loose, he added. Trump's planned trip was revealed just days after Abbott said he would be restarting building the border wall. It says, Trump, and I quote, he said, drug dealers, MS-13 gang members, human smugglers, sex traffickers, and criminal elements of the world now have free rein. Hospitals and schools are getting crushed, and public health is being sacrificed, all in service of the radical left anti-borders agenda. Our brave border agents and courageous ICE officers have been illegally stopped from doing their jobs. Our nation is now one giant sanctuary city for dangerous criminals. Like I say, though, the only problem I got with that is that actually, that's not the people that you were capturing and keeping in housing in the facilities. Actually, it was, again, women and children who you were separating from the woman and doing horrific shit like making sure the woman couldn't have any children once they left our country, which is crazy as hell. Could you imagine if people started doing that to white women, just collecting and picking up white women and children, throwing them in cages, and then sterilizing all the white women, taking out their wombs, taking out their ovaries and shit? Would you be okay with that? Would that be cool with you? Would you still consider them the banditos? But anyway, so that happened. Listen, man, I ain't got no love for Democrats. The Republicans are just jackasses, man. Point blank, man. I'm sorry. They're jackasses.